Hello everyone, my name is Ayarshit, and in this video we will see how to create a GUI which enable us to classify a sound from three different sounds. The three different given sounds are train, speech and fan respectively. Let's remember the order. One represents the train, two represents speech and three represents fan. Now let's take a look at the layout of the GUI, and this is the layout of GUI. It has a select down drop down where we can select the where user can select whether he wants to observe the graph of fan, speech or train, and here he can select the quantity which he wants to plot, that is mean, variance, squinness or kurtosis, and this button enables user to plot the graph. So what we will do in this GUI is we will consider the date, first 30 minutes data of each sample, and we will find these four quantities for each one, and we will store that in a new file variables.mat which is used to get confusion matrix. And since we have the sampling frequency 16 kilohertz, so for each second we will have 16,000 samples, and we will consider 16,000 samples as one block. So on a total we will have, for 30 minutes of data, we will have 30 into 60, so total 1800 blocks. So we will calculate all these four quantities for each and every block of 1800 blocks, and after calculating those values we will consider the next 30 minutes data of each sound, so that there also we will have 1800 blocks, and we will calculate four quantities of each block, and we will get confusion matrix, that is whether a train classifies train or not, that is whether train classifies train or it classifies fan or etc. Now we will see the code written for this GUI. So we wrote a callbacks function for plot button pushed. Here first we will read first 30 minutes data and calculate mean, variance, skewness, kurtosis for train, and again we will calculate the second 30 minutes data and we will calculate mean, variance, skewness, kurtosis for train. Similarly for speech we will calculate, and for fan also we will calculate, and we will save them with variables. This part of the code is just written to see the plots of each type. Suppose user selects to see mean of train, then he can get mean of train plotted on UI axis and mean of each and every quantity plotted in a separate figure window. And if user enters a wrong parameter or selects a wrong parameter, a message box with error message is displayed. And coming to threshold values, we will define threshold values, that is we will consider an interval in the first 30 minutes of data for each sound, train, speech and fan, and for each quantity we will define an interval, that is if any block having mean value lying between this interval, then it is supposed to be classified as train. Similarly for variance, skewness, kurtosis for train and for speech and fan also. And we will save the variables in a variables.mat file using this command. So this is the program which will be executed when plot button is pushed, and when the refresh button is pushed then UI axis will not, the graph will be cleared and threshold values will be cleared. Now coming to the second part, first we will see GUI layout. Here we have a button get confusion matrix refresh and a confusion matrix display box. When the user selects get confusion matrix, a confusion matrix should be displayed in this particular box, the code for this particular part. So here first we have to load whatever values we got, and here we have defined six variables A, B, C, D, F, and if user selects mean, then threshold values should be this, and same in case of variance, skewness and kurtosis, the threshold values differ, and we will define three different results, result 1, result 2, result 3, which are arrays. If user selects mean, that results will be mean, and similarly for variance, skewness and kurtosis. And here what we will do is we will compare each and every element of result 1, result 2, result 3, whether it belongs to the interval A, B, C, D and E, F, and finally we will get the total number of elements which are classified as train, fan, and sound for each type of quantity, mean, variance, skewness, and kurtosis. And here we have one more button, refresh button. When it is pushed, confusion matrix will show nothing. So this is the code of the GUI, and we will try to run the GUI. So this is the MATLAB app sound classifier. Suppose we want to observe fan mean plot here, and we want to observe mean of fan speed and train, and so we have to push plot. Since we are taking 1800 blocks, it takes some time to execute. I am skipping that part. This is the output when we click plot button. This plot corresponds to the mean of fan for second half, that is the one which is being tested. And in this figure window, we can observe three different plots. The first one is mean of train, and second one is mean of speech, and third one mean of fan. These means corresponds to the first 30 minutes of each of the data. And now let's get confusion matrix. So suppose we want to get confusion matrix for mean. We already selected mean, so when we click the get confusion matrix button, we will get the confusion matrix. And the first row indicates mean of train. As you selected mean, the first row is mean of train, the second one is mean of speech, and the third one is mean of fan. This rows corresponds to true values, and the columns corresponds to testing values. And here it shows that 1787 tested values of mean of train corresponds to original mean of train. That means this gives true values. So the diagonal elements gives true blocks. That is how many blocks are correctly classified. Here we get 1800 misclassified. So mean gives a wrong classification of the sound. Now let's select variance and observe. So this is the confusion matrix of variance, and diagonal elements are greater than other elements, and so we can observe that variance gives the exact or more accurate result compared to mean. And now let's select skewness and click get confusion matrix button. So this is the confusion matrix what we get. The diagonal elements are greater than other elements, so this gives the correct classification. But in this case 1781 is somewhat greater. And this indicates that the measured skewness of fan is almost similar to the actual skewness of train. So there is a contradiction between fan and train in skewness. So now let's observe kurtosis, get confusion matrix. And this is the kurtosis confusion matrix. And as usual, the diagonal elements are having a more number of blocks correctly classified. So indicates that using kurtosis also we can classify a sound, whether it belongs to train or whether it belongs to speech or whether it belongs to fan. So this is the GUI which enables us to classify a sound, and using this we can whether a sound belongs to fan, train, speech by taking 1800 blocks, that is a block each of duration 1 second. And from next experiment, we will do for 250 millisecond and 500 millisecond also. Thank you.